Hey guys, Retro Badger here. Hope you're all doing well. This is the Stormcrow, and it's a Griffin class runabout variant. It has its own unique sound effects, which is cool. It's designated as a tactical assault craft. The ship is very powerful for its size, but it is somewhat limited by its torpedo capacity. I've also noticed as well, there's a skull and crossbones on the side. I can almost see this as being like a ship that would carry Makos, possibly, but of course I don't know if they exist in future Starfleet, but the equivalent. I can imagine this ship carrying troops, that's for sure, and assaulting enemy bases. I thought a good first test would be against a Ferengi Marauder. I can imagine the Ferengi would be interested in acquiring a ship like this. Let's see what happens. Okay, here we go. Now, as you can see down there, we're equipped with quantum torpedoes. Although we only have 10 of those, so we've got to be careful. We have phasers, and we have a pretty nifty pulse phaser. Look at that. But the Ferengi Marauder is a pretty powerful ship, at least this version. As others have pointed out, not every Ferengi Marauder is created equal. It's usually down to the ship's captain and what weapons they equip. Ferengi Marauder, though, in my experience, at least in Bridge Commander, can give the Galaxy class a run for its money. The Galaxy class is ultimately more powerful, though. We've collapsed the shield. Ooh, don't crash into them. Oh, crumbs! Hey, Ashley, can we not beam aboard with our Makos? Make a deal with the Ferengi? Give me all of your latinum, and I'll stop firing on you. Actually, the Makos could just take all the latinum. Shields are at 75%. Okay, we have lost some systems here.
Target hull integrity at 20%.
Our ventral shields are draining, sir.
Oof, there we go. Very impressive. Wow. Well, we managed to pull that off, but could we do something even more crazy? Yep, this is going to be pushing it. So basically, we're going to put two of these against the one and only Enterprise F. I don't know if this is even possible. I've never tried anything like this. Okay, we've actually scored some hull damage there. That's incredible. Oh, look at that pulse phaser! I'm telling you, Federation shields do not like sustained fire. Oh, I've lost my... Oh, wait, no. Okay, I'm going to pull back a little bit now. Getting a bit concerned. Their hull is down to 50%. I'm assuming this fighter may be from the 25th century. Oh no! We've lost all weapons! Don't try and annoy Admiral Shelby on Frontier Day. Different tactic. I think we can take him. I really do. Let's hope they target the other one. Nope, they're going after us. You know though, I have noticed the computer can switch targets. In certain circumstances. Ah, there we go. It must have gone out of its engagement range. Also, if you cloak as well, that can upset things. Usually with pulse phasers and cannons, I always burn them out in this game. So I gotta be careful. I don't want to burn this one out. Oh, crumbs. Oh no! We've lost the Stormcrow! Oh! We're drilling into the side there. Ah! Shields, come on! Oh, flippin' heck! Well, it was worth a try, all in good fun. The Stormcrow is a very capable ship. Starfleet would definitely have a need for something like this. What do you guys think of it? Thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. Bye for now.